I am Tou Ger Billy Lor. I am from Eau Claire, Wisconsin, and I am a college student and also a shaman.
Can women do or make the altar?
I think they can. A lot of times, they won't let you build the altar. As a shaman, you're not allowed to build your own altar, whether you're a man or woman. And a lot of times, Hmong people don't. They're like, oh, bunny, it's a build altar. But my altar was built by women. If you're strict and you're really more of the patriarchal ways, then but I say a woman can make it too. It's not just men.
Why do women have to wait to be married in order to become a shaman? Is it a man-made rule or is it spiritual?
That is, I will say it 100%, that is a man-made rule. It is not a spiritual rule. I have seen many women who are not married and who have become master shamans. The reason, or why we keep saying that is because it's another contemporary issue. But yeah, Hmong-za patriarchal ways that we are a patriarchal culture. Why should we put effort into if in the end right? And so Hmong-la is just this narrows down to the patriarchy that our culture is really the systematic patriarchy that our culture is in. And Kanama, it's not, because a lot of people say, woman, if you must be married before you come to, which is, it's actually not true, because they just want, because they're like, oh, then try to, you're going to try to, you're going to, like, for example, you're going to, you, and, but the biggest reason I Hmong hai them, because, but spiritually, you have supportive parents who you are a woman no matter what you do. If you are a shaman, you can become a master. You don't need a man or you don't need the family of a man to help you. You can still become a full-fledged shaman.
What happens to divorced women when they die and their ex-husband's family no longer claims them as their people or their own family?
I think with that, it's not really a question that's really based towards shamanism. But with that, it's more of a Kijerakwa question, or more of a Hmong cultural or belief question. Hmong yizunzheng, the patriarchal view, right? Hmong yizunzheng, and till this day, we haven't made a move or change on this yet. But bingjing de dun tsai, nu de dong lo lo, nu mo lo nang lo, chin dao, ye mong de got the mu ito dan de lo, ye got so ye got teach the ra lo. That's why to pay or chong a dun tsai, to get dong lo mo ye pay at the sun dun tsai, so ti ra la shai o. Nu mu lo ye bechi, bechi ga, nu mo lo nang ye mu ito dan bechi hun play lo lo. And Khanama, it's very a contemporary issue because to nu chin dao lo ne. And a lot of times it's very tragic that those women who want to stay within Kijerakwa, want to stay within Hmong shamanism, animism, they are forced to leave the belief. They're forced to find something else, find new refuge, because the system, the cultural system and the cultural belief does not welcome them back anymore. And now you call the Hmong one that the goose or goose that you go. And you call very, it's a very sexist belief. And it's something that I believe that with the patriarchy, the Hmong patriarchy, not the men who established this rule, men join them, because the reason why it's all about face, about honor. It's about the reputation and face, which is something that
right?
right? Nu po mong kay nu po chung chang don nela. Nu tu sa to ita she tua. E nu po mong kay don ne. Sa kay chang don ne te ya mong li po chi tau bi te yan tu chi po ya ma. Kamo sa ra pe mo pe mong tamo sa te. With the Hmong folks in the community, we have to understand that, you know, with this rule that we always say that, oh, we can't change, but even though we're changing constantly, is I think it is really the patriarchy really feeling vulnerable, and they're scared, and they don't want to lose that power and that position, because Hmong men are automatically validated when you're born and you're male. You're automatically validated as, you know, you have... And so when, you know, Hmong, it's all about they don't want to let down that this is my pride, that is just sending them off to other gods. But then don't lose face. And this is, I think, a very big issue these days, and something that especially the Hmong folks and the Hmong community in the United States is something we still really need to move towards and really critically think about this and come together and make these issues, you know, come together and try to resolve and be intentive about resolving these issues.